I'm coughing. We've left those sands long ago, and it still persists. What does Crest even smoke? It's terrible. In any case, I'm better now.
I hate to interrupt, guys, but you should come to the mess hall. The table is almost served.
Thanks, Stepan. We'll be there in a moment. Shall we go, Artyom? Or shall we stay a little longer? It's so nice. You know, Artyom, I've been looking at Stepan and Katya, you and me, and thinking how lucky we are. It was so different with my parents. It was bad. Did I ever tell you why my mom died? Of course I didn't. It was because of Dad. He used to be even harsher back then. He used to come home from the barracks and reach for the bottle while taking off his boots. They'd quarrel, and then he'd stop appearing for a time. And while he was away, she'd start drinking too, and crying when she was sober. She'd feel better, would get kind of dreamy when drunk. You know how she used to call me, just A. She'd hug me and say, "One day, A, you and I are going to go to Vladivostok, the city I was born in. And from there to a village on the ocean shore." I was 5 back then and didn't really get much. But I could imagine that village and the ocean so vividly because I believed her. And then she killed herself, drank some kind of poison. Father quit drinking after Mom's death. Didn't ever pay much attention to me, but with her gone, he'd never leave me alone. Took me along everywhere. We only talked about her a couple of times, though. I used to have this doll, Jana. I played make-believe that she was my daughter, and we went to the ocean together. Then my father hid it, told me it got lost. He probably didn't want me to agonize over Mom's dream. Then I imagine she grew up and went to Vladivostok. And now I'm going, not to Vladivostok, but with you. The dream came true. By the way, I was always intrigued by what Dad dreams about. He should have some dreams, but what are they? Higher rank? He could choose any. Saving people? What would the saved do next? Sit underground? I never understood him. What does he hope for in life? What makes him happy? Nothing, perhaps. He never really had any time to think about tomorrow. Down in the metro, those thoughts don't come casually. Here on the surface, though. I, for one, have something I want to do. I want to run through the sand barefoot. Build a sandcastle for the kids. I'm imagining two. A boy and a girl. The boy would be a copy of you. We'd go swimming with mountains behind us. Wooden houses on the shore. The sun would wake us up every day, rising from the ocean. That harbor is our destination. Worth going there, even if we have half the world to cross. Everyone should have a destination. A point on the map where they aspire to go, and where one could finally be happy. All our guys have their own. Duke used to have one. Damir, another. We broke out of the metro and are now starting to scatter. Not at once, of course. At first, we're all still running together, searching. But eventually, each of us will find a point like this and stay there. I don't know where my dad's destination is. Don't know where yours is either. But I know I love you a whole lot. Go, Artyom. I'll rest some more and join you later.
What do you know?
Everything is perfect, Artyom. Follow us.
Don't you worry. You'll get another chance.
A moment of your attention, please. Half a year on the road, and 4,000 clicks behind us. We have been through a lot. Duke, Damir. All right, people. I do understand I can't keep it a secret much longer. After a careful study of the satellite maps we've obtained, and much deliberation, we've found a place we could call our new home. It is a river valley. There's forest and a hydroelectric power plant. This place is quite far from densely populated areas, which, as our journey has proven, is important. We're about 2 days away from it now. So, congratulations!
Yeah!
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 Yet, this is not our last order of business for today. Stepan, Katya.
Oh, rings!
Stepan, Katya, repeat after me. I take you to be my spouse.
I take you to be my spouse.
And vow to hold you from this day forward.
And vow to hold you from this day forward. For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish until death do us part. A As the captain of this ship, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. Live long and be happy. Oh, and
Gorka!
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 What's it? Oh!
Anna, what's happening?
Be careful, people!
Anna, please hold on.
What's happening? What is it, Anna?
What's that cough?
Gotcha. Do something. Please!
Don't cover her! Give her air!
Damn.
I'm sorry, I didn't say anything.
What are you talking about, baby?
In the Yamantau, when they dragged me away, that ghoul doctor said my lungs were falling apart. The gas I breathed in that ammo dump said
How
I don't have lungs.
How can you believe that monster? We've just been through a desert and all that sand, so that might be the reason. Katya, Artem, a few words.
I'm all right, Artyom. Go. I'm fine now.
I don't know about this. The old man is furious.
Oh, Artyom's getting chewed out today.
It's not Artyom's fault. I fell into that stupid bunker all by myself. And if Dad says one word to him about it, I'll tear him a new one.
Yes. In any case, Katya will calm the colonel down. You shouldn't worry either. She'll fix you in no time at all. She's good.
So, son, care to tell me what
Colonel,
do we do now?
Let us not panic and think constructively.
So, Katya, what do you think?
I think that trusting some degenerate's diagnosis wouldn't be wise. A move from humid metro into the desert with its dry heat and sandstorms is a stress for
us. Yes, I do think she'd be hit really bad right off the start had it
been gas.
My
thoughts exactly. Thus, first I'll check her condition to the best of my knowledge. Also, we're approaching the valley with its forest air. That alone could heal her.
I'm sorry to intervene, but did something happen?
Oh, Anna coughed up some blood.
My God. Do you really think it's the sand? Sounds more like TB to me, that's for sure.
TB we can handle. We've got enough antibiotics, and air does help with that.
What if that degenerate was right, Katya? What do we do? Is there medicine?
There was an air defense battery station in our village. Right on the brink of war, they received a new drug. It saved a lot of people after gas exposure and general poisoning. I'll check my mom's records and find its name. I think it was produced in Novosibirsk.
Right, Novosibirsk. Yermak, your opinion.
For Anna's sake, I'd go to the edges of the earth. As for Novosibirsk, it's about 2,000 clicks.
Then it's decided. We head for the valley. If it is suitable, we settle there. If Anna's state worsens, I'll take a group of volunteers to find that drug. So Katya, please, find that name for us.
I'll find it. Don't worry.
One more thing, Artyom. I want no surprises in that valley. You are our most seasoned scout. So take the rail car, one volunteer, go check everything out before we arrive. Let's go back for now. Tell Anna and the people to calm down. Poor girl. Now I understand why she was so down. Just imagine thinking about the back.
Oh.
I can't say I've ever been religious, but right now I'm begging all gods, please, watch over Anna and make the valley cure her of her affliction. In the meantime, Alyosha and I are on a recon mission. We have no idea of what is waiting for us there. Though Alyosha seems convinced that there are going to be crowds of women eagerly anticipating his arrival. If that turns out to be the case, then I have the best companion possible for this mission.